University was first founded in 1915 as the first Catholic college for women in the state of Pennsylvania. Now, in 2023, Marywood is home to roughly 2,000 students and 400 staff members. Although from the outside looking in, Marywood may seem just as ordinary as any other college, in reality, rumors are constantly flooding through the student body revolving around the subtle dark energy that may be surrounding campus.
For generations, both students and staff have claimed that Marywood is haunted, and there may be a reason for this.
Our story may begin in 1971 with a disastrous fire at the Marywood Mother House. The Mother House building was originally the Marywood Seminary, and it also served as housing for sisters on the Marywood College faculty. The fire injured 9 nuns and altered the lives of over 100 sisters. In a WNEP article, Sister Dorothy Kibler said, "It was a terrible, eerie feeling that night." In our research, the only cause we could find was that of an unknown substance mixing with a steam-type radiator.
Suspected homicide victim continues in Scranton.
Spawned one of the city's newest cold case mysteries.
Today marks the 5th anniversary of the death of Sister Angela Miller.
Another tragedy struck when Sister Angela Miller and her sister Rosemary Smith were presumed dead and victims of homicide. The suspected killer was Alan Smith, Rosemary's son, who also died after setting the home on fire. Though Rosemary's body was found in the torched house, Sister Angela's body is still missing.
My name's Michael Romano. I'm a junior business management major at Marywood University. Since the Mother House burned down, which was the big incident on Marywood, you know, that caused a lot of trauma. So some say in the middle of the night, living in Regina or anywhere on campus, you could actually smell the burning. And there's been a lot of stories, even from like back in the 70s, I've interviewed people. The lights flicker at night. There's times like the power goes out here alone. The fire alarms always go off. I used to live here for a year. They'd always go off at odd times of the night. So Loughran Hall's probably one of the more reported halls as well with ghost activity. That's where all the freshmen are. You hear of freshmen playing with Ouija boards, trying to summon something. And while, you know, a lot of people think that's fun and innocent, in the ghost community, there's a lot of talk that Ouija boards open up portals that ghosts come through. And it does kind of make sense if you believe. There's also rumor that the bottom of Log was the morgue for the nuns back in the day, so that they kept all the dead bodies there. A lot of people say that they sense something in their rooms.
We took to the experts at NEPA Paranormal to see if these devastations could really lead to hauntings.
I am Gina Bankston, and we run ghostly excursions together, taking people on some of the craziest ghost hunts in the, you know, on our coast.
Why do traumatic events trigger hauntings?
A ghost is someone that dies and is here, right? You're still having all of the human emotions. But that poor soul that is here, that for whatever reason does not want to cross over because they're afraid to, that's where the trouble is.
People have allegedly seen nuns who have died in the hallways, and there were doors swinging open by themselves. Could this be a sign of negative energy or just something trying to get attention?
I would go more on the latter. I would say it's something trying to get your attention.
Lots of students are like, oh, a ghost. You would say it's not something to be afraid of?
No.
Like, not to us. I mean, we can't say it for you guys, like a newbie or somebody who doesn't, yeah, you know, it doesn't happen all the time to them.
Whatever's there isn't harmful.
There's nobody getting scratched or, you know, pushed downstairs or anything like that, right?
No,
I wouldn't say that it's negative.
Yeah, they're watching over their building. They're doing their thing that they've always done. They're watching out for the kids. They're, you know, if a door is open that should be shut, maybe they're going to shut it. Or if a door is shut that should be open, like, you know, if there's something inappropriate going on in there, I'm going to open this door. It's a nun. That's what they're going to do. So what would the nun do?
I think it could be haunted. It's like a Catholic campus, so anytime you kind of bring that in, there raises the rumor, is it haunted or not? There's been a lot in the area and the campus that's potentially brewing for a ghost to appear.
So, is Marywood really haunted?
Well, we may never know.